What is up, everybody? Tubber vs. TV here today, or today I'm gonna be film vs. TV because we're gonna talk about this new movie. This new movie, Transformers Rise of the Beast, looks insane. So, if you are a Transformers fan, or maybe you aren't a Transformers fan, this new movie looks really good. Like, I know the Transformers movie has, like, they get a lot of flack from being director Michael Bay. People don't like the main movies, but it's kind of strange. People who hate on the movies, but they do really well in theaters. Like, they sell a lot of money. They sell a lot in theaters. Like, they do insane at the box office. But these movies receive a lot of hate. But this new one, with the Beast, like, Beast Wars was my childhood Transformers as a kid. Like, I know a lot of people probably grew up with the original Transformers, like the original when Optimus was like a truck, a red, white, and blue truck, or like Optimus was a I guess, yeah, Optimus was a truck, but I grew up with Optimus being a gorilla, and Megatron being a T-Rex. That's the one I grew up with as a kid, and I was like, it's just cool to see this on a big screen. Like, they actually look, it looks really dope, the designs they did for this one. So, I am definitely excited for this. This is definitely gonna get me back in the theaters to watch this one. Like, I am definitely looking forward to this. And it was like, even like the reaction from people in the comment section, like, people are saying this looks really good. Just looking at the comments, let's go, this looks great, can't wait. People are actually praising it, because usually the Transformers movies get a lot of flack for them being trash, but people are actually excited for this one, so this is probably the rebirth for the rebirth of the series that it needed, because this is probably such a huge nostalgia grab for a lot of people my age who grew up with Beast Wars instead of Transformers, so definitely looking forward to this. it looks pretty good, it looks really good so far. Like, I can't show up because of copyright strikes, but this trailer looks amazing. Like, I'm definitely on board for this, what they got for this new film. And I didn't say this for any other Transformers film, which is crazy. I was really a big fan of the Transformers films, but this one looks really good, in my opinion. So, Heat, this is fire. OMG, so cool. Am I becoming a Transformers fan? I wouldn't even call myself a Transformers fan, because I only really liked Beast Wars as a kid, but the other Transformers, though, I couldn't really relate, I couldn't really grasp, because I grew up with the Beast Wars as a kid, but this is definitely making me want to go to the theaters to watch this, because they got the Optimus Prime that we know from the movies interacting with the Optimus, that's the gorilla right here, the gorilla Transformer as well, so it's kind of cool. You can see both of them interact. I know Netflix did like a series where they had like the Beast Wars interacting with the Transformers. That was a cool series I watched for a little bit. But yeah, this is looking really good. My childhood on the silver screens. Yeah, he's probably around the same age as me then. What happened to just being cars? You must not know it's a whole generation of people who didn't grow up with them being cars, but they was actually animals. That's the generation I grew up with. Like, we didn't know them as cars or trucks or whatever. We knew them as these different animals who transformed to these robots. So, hell yeah. I need to go. I love Transformers. And F all the people who were hater nations toward the franchise. Yeah, this series has so much hate before in the past. But now people, I don't see anybody hating on this at all. Which is people are pretty much in unison saying they want to go see this movie, see this new one. So, this might be the rebirth of the franchise. I know the last movie, the Bumblebee movie, did pretty good. That did decent. Like, they had, like, it didn't get as much hate as the other ones did. But this new one might be, like, the game changer for these movies actually being, like, respected at the theaters now. Because before, these movies were not respected. Especially after they did the second one, where the robots were speaking like an Ebonics. People were like, this is a trash series after that. Like, they got no respect whatsoever. But now, once they did, like, Bumblebee, got some respect. And this might be what actually puts it into being, like, respected series at this point. I wouldn't say up to, like, the MCU level, but it's definitely up there at this point. This with the feedback from this trailer. Where the hell is Rat Trap? Where's my stupid rat? I want to see him. They even showed the cheetah one. They showed the cheetah. I think they showed the rhinoceros one. Yeah, where is Rat Trap? We got to see the giant rat. You know what? That might be stupid for people who haven't seen this show, but that rat was definitely one of the main characters. He's definitely like the comic relief of the show, which they got to have him. They got to have him up in here as well too. So. I don't care what anyone thinks of Transformers. Every time I see them on the screen, I feel like a kid again. Yeah, this is definitely a big nostalgia trip for a lot of people, especially seeing like the one you grew up with as a child on the big screen. And the transformations look much simpler and less cool. I miss Michael Bay. Okay, so apparently Michael Bay isn't doing these ones. I didn't know that. I know he did the original ones. I guess he's not doing the newer ones. If you're wondering why the Transformers look way more like G1, it's because Bumblebee was a reboot. Also, OG list looks great. Yeah. Me, man, those Bayformers movies were so lame. Who cares about them anymore? As Optimus Primal Cheetor. Okay, Optimus Primal is what's his name. I thought it was just Optimus Primal. Optimus Primal is what his name is. Cheetor and Rhinox. Yeah, these are the ones I grew up with as a kid. Yeah. Give me tickets now. Yeah, I'm in the same boat. Like, I would never go to the theaters to go see this one. The robosexuals and the furries about to meet at an intersection of terrifying proportions. What? Hey, I guess that's your thing. Like, I don't know. I'm gonna judge you. I love how these movies don't care and recon the previous ones. Transformers just arrived. I mean, they've been here since the pyramids. Oh, also the moon landing was for them. Oh, they're dinosaurs too. By the way, King Arthur was real. You know what? Screw it, Beast Wars. I don't care what story they make along, because as long as I get to see them on a big screen, I don't care. Like, I'm not really invested in the Transformers lore or whatever they have for the past few movies. I just want to see them on a big screen. I think that's probably most people. Like, they really don't care about whatever story they had. I just want to see these characters on the big screen. Considering how good Bumblebee was, it's about time that I have a genuine trust in the new Transformers line. This series looks like a ton of fun. Is that a Transformers gorilla? Saying someone who never watched the original series, because if you watched it, you knew that Optimus Prime was a gorilla. That's nothing shocking. Oh, this looks awesome. Plenty of robots for this movie to not focus on the humans as much. Optimus Prime looks very gray, and I like Bay and Bumblebee versions better. Primal and the Maximals we can see look cool. I would need to see Wheeljack immediately. I don't know who that is. Okay. Why am I excited about this trailer? I hate live action Transformers movies, but I like these designs better. And I love these characters that are my favorites. Okay. My inner child right now. What is this? Yeah, for real. Real cinema is back. I've been patiently waiting for this trailer and this movie. I am so hyped to see it. Let's go. Yeah, people. I'm just so excited. Other people are just excited about this. Like, this was a whole generation of 90s kids finally get to see the Transformers they grew up on a big screen, which doesn't happen because we didn't know how this series is going to go because it got so much flack from the Michael Bay movies that we didn't think this was ever going to happen. Now it's finally happening. We finally get to see this on the big screen. The Beast Wars on the Beast Transformers on the big screen, which is pretty cool. And so my issue is the whole point of transforming is to hide and disguise yourself. If you're like a giant robot gorilla, well, you're not going to fool 81, so there's literally no point just transforming at all. Then someone has to ruin it. It's like, bro, this is a show that was made for kids. I don't think, like, if you're a grown adult, like, sure, if you want to nitpick it, it's not going to make sense. But as a kid, this is the thing back in the day. But I guess he does have a point. Like, if it's a big giant gorilla and a big cheetah running around, it's not gonna be disguised by anything. So I don't know. I think people are thinking way too hard about this and not realize people just want to see these characters that grew up with as a kid on the big screen. That's pretty much it. So I'm gonna conclude it right here. Definitely want to see your thoughts down below. If you have seen the trailer, if you have grew up with this series, maybe you have seen the series, what do you think about this one? Leave comments down below. Leave a like this video. As always, thanks for watching and peace.